Hi friends, please subscribe to Amravati Media and press the bell icon for more latest updates.
Today, 95% of India's trading by volume and 70% by value is through maritime transport. Indian ports handled approximately 1.2 billion metric tons of cargo traffic in the year 2019-20. And much required policy reforms like 100% FDI, Make in India, Sagarmala, and Bharatmala have been introduced to ensure exponential growth in the sector. I'm sure that Maritime India Vision 2020-30 document would certainly stand as a testament to the government's commitment in this regard. Sir, I believe that the importance of blue economy in a nation's growth story extends much beyond the maritime trade and the export-import statistics. The true value of blue economy is unlocked only when all the allied sectors, which are directly and indirectly dependent on the oceans, such as aquaculture, maritime and coastal tourism, chemical and biotechnological exploration, shipbuilding, and other port-related industries also mature enough to provide sustainable employment and growth opportunities. The draft of the first ever national fishing policy released by the Government of India in September 2020 is an example of several such solid steps taken in this direction. Honorable Prime Minister, sir, drawing inspiration from your focused agenda to take India's maritime economy to the next level, Andhra Pradesh state government has taken up a lot of transformative steps to leverage its coastal line of 974 kilometers, which is the second longest in India and the longest on the eastern coast of the country, sir. Today, I am proud to say that Andhra Pradesh is ranked number one in the country in ease of doing business rankings 2020, released by the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India. See, one of the factors, sir, that contributed to this achievement is the state government's consistent efforts in developing port infrastructure, support ecosystem, and encouraging port-led industrialization. Andhra Pradesh has one major port in Visakhapatnam, sir, 5 functional state ports, and 10 other notified state ports with world-class facilities that handle more than 170 million tons of cargo per annum, second only to Gujarat. Andhra Pradesh state shares 4% of the total Indian exports, and we aim to reach 10% share by 2020-30, sir. In recent times, several industrial nodes have come up in the state with ports as the focal point for development to further unlock the potential offered by the long coastline of AP. The government of Andhra Pradesh has undertaken development of 3 greenfield ports at Ramayapatnam, Machilipatnam, and Bhavanpadu on an innovative model that mitigates all risks associated with the greenfield port development, thereby making the port operation a risk-free proposition for the private sector. After the development of the port by the government, the operator of the port would be selected on competitive bidding basis, ensuring maximum revenue realization for the government and providing risk-free investment opportunity to the investor. These all-weather deep-drafted ports are all set to be operational by 2020-23. Creating an additional capacity of at least 100 million tons of cargo per annum in the short term, with the potential to grow leaps and bounds in the long term. In order to ensure that the ports operate at their fullest capacities, the state government has consciously taken steps to attract large investments in the sectors ranging from manufacturing, petrochemicals, food processing, pharmaceuticals, etc., which are port dependent. The state government, with the support of the Government of India, while promoting skilling by establishing an aqua university, has also undertaken the development of 8 fishing harbors, establishment of testing labs and cold chain facilities to provide better ecosystem for the aquaculture, thereby increasing the share of aqua-related cargo from the ports. All such well-calibrated interventions are designed to promote port-based industries and develop new economic cities driven by the ports all along the coastline of Andhra Pradesh. Lastly, sir, I would like to extend my invitation to the representatives from various companies from India and abroad attending this summit through the Government of India to invest in Andhra Pradesh, and I assure you the best environment for your operations and the fullest support in making your endeavor a successful one. Thank you, sir.